Is Airbnb short-term rental dead in Toronto? Hi there, I'm Nawar Naji, a real estate broker with Chestnut Park in the city of Toronto. In the last few days, the Local Planning Appeal Tribunal, which is known as LPAT, sided with the city in Toronto in implementing the short-term rental rules. So here's what it means for real estate investors who are into the short-term rental game of real estate investing. Number one, you cannot short-term rent a non-owner occupied property. So if you look at it, there's two types of properties. One is owner-occupied, where the owners live there, and there's the non-owner-occupied. So if you own a condo downtown or a duplex, those properties that the owner does not live in cannot be short-term rentals anymore moving forward. Now, with respect to the owner-occupied properties, so if the owner lives in their house, they will be allowed to rent their entire house for up to 180 days out of the year. So half a year approximately. Now, if the owner lives in a duplex or a triplex, that second unit or third unit cannot be short-term rented by the owner. It has to be a long-term lease moving forward. Now, the question becomes, one is, will Airbnb appeal this decision? And the second thing is the enforcement. How will the city of Toronto enforce these rules moving forward? If you're looking to invest in real estate, whether it's short-term or long-term, or have any questions with respect to the short-term rules in the city of Toronto, please feel free to reach out. Thanks for watching, and make sure you click on like and subscribe. And until next time, happy investing.